Sterling Properties of Santa Barbara proudly presents Ken Boxer Live. From the American Riviera in Santa Barbara, California, it's Ken Boxer Live with your host, Ken Boxer, and co-host, two-time Olympian Tai Babilonia. Please welcome Ken and Tai.
Welcome to Ken Boxer Live. I'm Ken Boxer. Let me introduce you to my very talented and very lovely co-host, Tai Babilonia, the two-time Olympian, yes, but she's also the five-time national champion as well as the world champion figure skater. Tai, welcome
to being
here.
Thank you.
So, who do we have on the show tonight?
This is surreal. It's really surreal, but the talk show host Larry King has dubbed our guest the first real reality show star. Kato Kaelin's in the house today.
Yes.
Kato Kaelin! Can you believe that?
When the OJ verdict was actually, and I think it was 95, what were you doing?
I was very pregnant with my son Scout. And I just remember, you know, the TV was always on, and we were glued to it.
As everybody else.
Yeah.
Well, let's get busy, right?
Shall we get busy?
Yes.
Don't go away. We'll be right back with Kato Kaelin.
Ken Boxer Live, brought to you in part by the Wildcat Lounge, repeatedly voted Santa Barbara's best dance club. The Eagle Inn, a family-owned hotel near the beach in Santa Barbara. And by Santa Barbara Chicken Ranch, authentic Mexican-style mesquite barbecue. Now back to Ken Boxer Live.
Thank you. And we are back. Joining us tonight and making his first appearance on our show is so well known. His name, of course, very popular actor, Kato Kaelin. Most of us remember Kato as one of the star witnesses from the so-called trial of the century, the O.J. Simpson murder trial. This was the case where O.J. Simpson was found not guilty for the murders of his ex-wife, Nicole Brown Simpson, and restaurant waiter, that is, Ron Goldman. What you may not know about Kato, however, is that he's also a very talented entrepreneur. His new line of men's clothing called Slackerwear is already an enormous sensation. And of course, we get to discuss Slackerwear with him in just a few moments. But first, let's meet our guest, Kato Kaelin.
Ken,
welcome.
Yay, Kato. Hi, sweetheart.
Good to meet you.
Thank you for being here.
And I've watched you skate many times.
Thank you.
I've seen you skate many times.
And she was wonderful. A world champion.
Still is.
Thank you. Still have it.
Still can skate. Will you skate?
Will I skate?
Right now.
Right here?
Let's do it, right? Yeah.
Get your checkbook out.
I'll get my checkbook. Yeah. My mother, actually, when I was growing up in Wisconsin, a lot of ice skating there. You can settle this argument. Is it called a double Lutz or double klutz? Because my mom called me a klutz.
It's a Lutz.
So much for that.
You could do a klutz.
Okay.
A very simple question.
We've done so much research on you. And now we didn't bring you all the way up here to just ask this simple question, but okay. How did you get the name Kato?
Kato is my middle name, but Kato comes from my mother and father. There was a show many years ago called The Green Hornet.
I remember.
I was in love with Bruce Lee. Everything he did, I tried to emulate Bruce Lee, and I took Jeet Kune Do. And I have three other brothers, and we'd always be fighting because when you grow up in a family of six, you got to fight for stuff.
Right.
So that's when they said, Kato, will you stop it? We'll get you mashed potatoes. Will you stop it? Because we're always fighting. So
How did it stick, though? It was your middle name.
Well, because I did some of the karate, and everybody kept calling me Kato. High school, I was a pitcher. It was Kato Kid. And it sort of just rolls off your tongue. Come on, Kato Kid.
It's perfect.
Try it, everybody. Kato Kid. Good enough.
No, it fits you though. It's perky and it's
yeah,
lively.
Yeah, many people think it's Asian. And it's because it's Bruce Lee was the Kato and everything's, you know, Bruce Lee. Now they did the remake of the Green Hornet, so there was a Kato in that. Pink Panther, people think it's not now Kato. There's a boomp on my head. That's also a Kato.
Well, was this your first time in Santa Barbara?
Say it again.
Is this your first time in Santa Barbara?
No, I've been to Santa Barbara. I used to do a wonderful person who passed away named Wendy Jo Sperber, and I did her golf tournament all the time, and it was just so much fun. So we played on her parents owned a golf course. I think it's called Glen Annie, is that it?
Right.
Yeah.
Sandpiper.
Wonderful.
Or something like that?
It's a beautiful course, but they don't do it anymore. They just do a poker tournament now.
And you're a poker fan, I know, of this.
Love poker. I have to tell you that there's my girlfriend. She has a tournament called the Love
Across
your the
girlfriend
Ocean.
Thing. You're beautiful and talented.
Oh my
girlfriend.
Gosh, she's lovely.
She's
go for it.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I Lena Wynn has changed my life. I honestly, people think it's goofy, but I am so in love with this person because she made that line in Jerry Maguire, "You complete me."
Yes.
I think it's the corniest line ever. But I'm living
it. Oh, he's about to jump on the couch. You're going to do another Tom Cruise?
Her charity is called Love Across the Ocean, Lato, and she does a poker tournament. She also, yeah. Okay. We met at her charity at the Laugh Factory while I was on the red carpet real quick, and I just saw her, and my eyes connected. I was a buddy of mine. I said,
you knew right away?
I said to her, it's not even my, I would never do this. I look, I said, I want to be with this woman. I just feel it.
So did you approach her, or did you?
I did.
How did you make the connection?
I went up to her and I said, Lena. She goes, my name's Lena.
Good start.
I said,
whoops.
Oh. I said, have we met before? And she says, no. I said, did you do a story on me? Do you want to?
You became so famous from the O.J. Simpson trial back, now it's 20 years.
Right.
I can't believe that.
And the one question I've always had, did you ever say to yourself, if they would have just asked me this one question, this might have changed the outcome?
You know,
is there any question?
There was absolutely nothing, no question. I was there to answer everything. When I met with the trial lawyers, both sides, prosecution and the defense, and I was a prosecuting witness. And you meet with them beforehand. They ask you questions that they'll be asking you. So there's nothing that they don't know. There's nothing that I would not answer for them to ask me. I think people, they assume, people saw me as the soap opera character, Kato, and it was the worst thing to do because I'm a human being and you go in to tell the truth. And if I did tell the truth, I didn't do that, it's not how I was raised.
Well, did you know what the public perception of you was as soon as you left the courtroom?
I think so. I think everybody, like I said, had an opinion. And some people said, you got famous from a trial. It's like, I didn't look for it. I didn't, it's the worst, having two people die that I knew Nicole, I didn't know Ron. Right. It's nothing anybody would wish for. And people say, would you change anything? You know what? No one gained anything from this. There's no good news in it.
Right.
The only people that gained in this is the media. It was a cash cow. It started four different networks. So they gained, they knew how to work it, and their symbol should be crime does pay for them. And that's basically it. There's no other good thing in the trial.
Well, we want to continue with that, the trial, but let's have people at home and here in the studio watch a little bit of your interaction at the O.J. Simpson trial. This is the first trial. This was not the civil case. This is when you first got on the stand. Let's watch.
Actually, when you watch this, I hate seeing it, but we'll watch it for your show.
Okay, let's watch.
Amazing.
Mr. Kaelin, is Kato your middle name?
A nickname.
Is that what people call you instead of Brian?
Yes.
You a little bit nervous today?
Feel great. A little nervous.
Now, were you an aspiring actor back then, sir?
Yes.
And you still are?
Yes.
Did you think it might be advantageous to you to stay with the defendant and get to know him for your acting career?
I didn't think that. I never asked for anything like that. I was getting rent-free, so we didn't ask anything.
Mm-hmm. Did you think that your friendship with him, your acquaintanceship, especially living on his property, might send acting roles your way?
I didn't think that. I never asked. I was hopefully getting things on my own. Mm-hmm. But if he'd bring up on his own. Mm-hmm. I don't think we're going for the same parts.
And when you gave him the $20 bill, did you put it in his hand?
Yes.
Could you see both his hands?
One hand, for sure, but I could see both hands, yeah.
Did you notice him bleeding or cut on either hand?
No.
And what happened next?
I gave him the money, and he said he was going to get hamburger, and I said, can I go?
You invited yourself to go with him?
Yes.
And what was his response to that?
Sure.
You seem real excited to have you come?
Objection. Sustained.
Wouldn't you?
Sustained.
Ladies and gentlemen, our guest, Kato Kaelin. He just joined us.
And watching that and me seeing it, that's just my energy. It's not me trying to be funny. I swear to you, in a courtroom, it's just my being. It's just who I am.
So,
and I wish I would have been funny on your show. I'm kidding.
You're so funny. You're naturally funny. My question is, did you come to Hollywood to pursue an acting career? And how did you end up at the guest house on Rockingham?
Great question, Ty. What happened was, I was reading, this is how bizarre life is. So the week before the murders happened, I read for a role. I had a callback for this role, and it was for a film called Dumb and Dumber. And the person producing it, his name is Aaron Meyerson, gave me the script months before, and they kept calling. I got a call back from the casting director, Rick Montgomery, and it was like, oh my God, my life is going to be terrific. I was an actor before everything, before that happened. I just became famous overnight where people recognized me, but I didn't change of who I was. If I was at a premiere, people could say, he's at the premiere because he's famous now, Kato. No, I did this all before. I was the same Kato. But people don't realize that I had goals before. You still struggle. I still have so many struggles because 20 years later, people still associate that with me.
When you audition, I mean, that's got to be so difficult going out for auditions.
Oh, yeah.
Do they take you seriously or
completely.
They just want to see you?
Yeah, I mean, work does happen. I'm just saying sometimes it's a curiosity for people to meet
me. Absolutely.
Right. And I'm not, looking at that, that's just, here I was a witness in a double homicide. The first time I've been in a courtroom in my entire life. Yeah, I was very nervous. And, but like I said before, nobody won in this thing. It was two people lost their lives. And the only thing was the media, and they really know how to work to get you to just to get the shows from. And I like Red of Ancestrum, but everybody got a show. A lot of the lawyers were.
That's interesting.
A lot of people made a lot of money.
Right.
And
was the civil case any different for you? Because you
had to
testify
sort of like
that.
I testified in that one. I think for 3 or 4 days, and it was the sort of the redo. That trial was in Santa Monica, where the original trial was supposed to be. But they chose downtown LA.
So when you actually watched the video, as we all did, going on in your mind, is it a blur, that first time you're on? Or do you see it enough times now where you go,
I don't see it enough times. It's something I never really want to see. I don't, you know.
Why is that? Why don't you want to see it?
Because it's a terrible time. And I think
and
for
you've
me,
moved
you
on.
Just right
you
now.
You gotta move on.
You know, you move on. I always live by this motto. Could you change anything? I can't change the past. I can only live my future in the present and making things great for myself and for people. And my motto, honestly, back then was pay it forward, and I'm always trying to make things better. And I love being jovial and bringing light to people and not the bad.
But I read, as I was doing my research, that you were quoted as saying, well, I'm going to paraphrase the quote, that you can't believe why so many people are still insistent on knowing more about the case. You know,
it's the first of its kind. It's the televisions in a courtroom. It was black and white.
Right.
And so many things are going on in the world today with black and white, with Ferguson and New York and strikes. Everything is about race. And unfortunately, I'm not going to get over that, ever. It's always going to be something with race of whoever. Black and white.
But are you surprised after 20 years, here's the anniversary, people are still interested in this one case?
And I'll tell you, FX, the network, is doing a 10-part series on the OJ trial as a TV series.
Are you serious?
Yeah, they're selling it. FX is already ordered. It's written by Ryan Murphy, who does a show called Glee, and Nina Jacobson, who did The Hunger Games.
Right.
And if you watch The Hunger Games, I'm just saying, one of the characters' names was Kato. Coincidence? Maybe, I don't know. It's written, it's based on Jeffrey Toobin's book.
Okay.
But like I said, so many people got involved in a situation and that had nothing to do with it. And I can walk in the street and everybody comes up to me and has an OJ story. And it's like, you do, I really don't, I'm just a gracious person, so I'll hear anybody out. I don't ever bring up the trial. I let other people bring it up. I try to bring up other things in my life, that's what's going on.
I mean, you were mobbed after the you know, you would come out of court and you were mobbed. What did that feel like?
Well, I never had like a publicist before. I had to get a publicist. Right. I had to, you know, the thing that's, malls would fill up to meet and greet, and I was blown away. That's the power of the media, though. The power of the media can also turn on you that fast, and they can make you, they can love you, and great things happen. An example is the Kardashian family. The Robert Kardashian was a lawyer.
Sure.
Now the Kardashians are a $1 billion empire.
Right. But you've been able to parlay a few things, and one of them being your acting career. You've done a few things. And
yeah, I did. Not so much parlay is something I've always. I've always been the same. Like I said, okay. I went on auditions back then, but yeah, I've had.
That was your
busy.
Major audition.
But we're going to see a clip though.
Oh, you
of
are.
Something that you did as you were
You're
being
acting
like Larry King.
Larry King.
Set us up.
Well, Larry's been a friend of mine since he called me the first reality star,
right.
And Larry King was, you know. I try to give him the guest house key on a show, and we just became friends. And as a matter of fact, anybody I do a show with, I pretty much stay in contact with, and except you two. And I. Whoa, what is
that? I know,
that? Mike
ding,
Tyson
ding,
here?
Ding, that that's good.
Where's Floyd Mayweather?
Let's go to this clip.
Okay, yeah, so Larry King, like I said, the reality. So I've done a show so many times that I thought I'd do a Larry parody on a. I work for the Movie and Music Network, where I do a show there.
Okay.
So this is from that.
That period.
Video on demand. No, I just did this recently.
Oh, okay.
Oh, cool.
Let's watch.
Yay. Ding.
Tonight on Larry King Live, an exclusive interview with arguably the most popular woman in America. She'll answer all rumors, true or not, Miss Kim Kardashian. Kim, give me a Kim Kardashian cereal that you'd eat.
Rice Krispies.
So it's white. The white Rice Krispies.
The cocoa kind?
The black, okay, Cocoa Puff.
Yes.
All right, so you like dark cereals too?
Yes, we do.
Fair to say? First time ever on national TV. Baby North with Kim Kardashian. Has daddy's nose.
Doesn't she?
Baby. Oh, she just said mommy.
No, Larry, she said money.
Money!
The
audience loved it! Come on, audience! Woo-hoo!
Okay.
Now, did you study with
you went to the academy,
acting?
Yes. Oh,
okay.
I studied for 7 years in academy. You never stopped studying.
Okay, but what did Larry King think about that?
Yeah.
Larry loved
so
it.
So funny.
Larry loved it, and Larry's boss, Carlos Slim, loved it, too.
Okay, well, in my introduction, we were talking about slackerware.
Yeah.
And that, as I said, is a sensation already.
Already.
It's just come out.
Tell us
just
about slackerware. How did it get started?
I became friends with a woman 23 years ago or more, a comedian named Rhonda Shearer. Rhonda became incredibly successful by selling a bra. The ladies here over here, the AAH bra.
Yes.
We have
it.
The number one selling bra in the world. So anyways, Rhonda and I became friends, and she said, I saw her at a party in LA, and she lives in Tampa Bay. And I said, I have this great idea. People for years have said I'm a couch crasher, or Kato Kaelin, you should be known as a slacker guy. And I said, you know what? Embrace your inner slacker. Why not do something where if people assume that I'm watching sports on a couch, make loungewear for it. So I call it slacker.
It's perfect.
Ingenious.
You love it. It's really good looking clothes.
Oh! How did that happen?
I don't know. I said slacker and this happened.
Okay.
So let's see.
This is one of these are the guys. How many times look at it, it says TV remote. How many times you on the couch and you go, "Where's the remote, honey?"
Perfect.
There you go.
So you're hands-on with this. You help design. Pick the material.
Kato Potato, the artist who does DC Comics, Batman and Superman, did the hang tag.
Perfect.
That's that. We have the sweatshirt.
Really,
so
put those
I'll hold. Yep.
And also, the great thing is slacker.
From God.
Yeah.
It's been sent.
That's down the side. Now, slacker, I have the K backwards because as you can see in life, sometimes it's good to take a step back to move forward.
So, very good.
There you go.
Feel this material.
So I love this. This is Kato, this is great.
Yeah, this is a
so how
bamboo.
Can this is on you so there's a website and where is this sold?
This is called slackerware.com and right now we're meeting with every of the all the shopping networks right now.
Right on.
We are meeting with
there
Ron
you
is
go.
Meeting. So you get that. Boy, do you like shorts?
I do.
Oh, Lena!
You do like shorts, huh?
Lena's good.
Slacker
those are
guys,
cute.
What do you think?
Those are cute.
These are
and they look
great.
So comfortable. So,
they are so comfortable.
So how many pieces in the line so far? This is
for the men, there'll be 8 pieces. Of,
okay.
Now, the women's line comes out in spring 2015, which is soon. They're hot potatoes and sweet potatoes. And when we start my kids' line, they're called cater tots. Come on, Ken.
There you go.
Hello.
Cater tots. You'll love this.
That is so great.
Who wants Ken to put on a robe?
Yeah.
Ken.
This is awesome.
The robe goes. Looks like this. It has the hoodie with the slacker. We're just feeling.
Okay.
Good. Keep your clothes in, though, Ken. Don't want to see you naked.
Oh,
but it's
I don't
really,
think anyone
it's
else
great
would
quality.
Either.
Oh, my
it's
gosh.
Good.
Boxers what? Wear that. Ken Boxer in a fighting robe.
Hello.
Hey.
There you go.
Ken Boxer.
Get it?
Let's see.
Hey, Mr. Olympia. Boxer.
I'll put this one
is so
sleeve
cool.
on.
Are you having fun with it?
It
look
is.
Look at this.
It's honestly, it is.
You love it.
People love it. I always name drop. I have to name drop this one story.
Name
quick.
Drop.
I name drop. The first person I gave the shorts to. Who loves them and wears them probably every day he's watching sports is Charlie Sheen.
Really?
Charlie will have it in anger management where he'll put these on.
Here we go. I'm going to.
So it's Slackerware. Wait a minute. What? Yes. Yeah, Steve wants a pair. She just asked, how do you get them? I'll tell you. You go to slackerware.com.
That's
slackerware.com.
It.
Slackerware.com.
Look at Ken, boxer.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Ken.
You too.
He
can
needs
look
that.
Like that.
He needs that from.
I look like a nun.
Flying nun.
You look like a good looking nun.
Look I love this. Congratulations.
Oh, yeah. I'm so excited.
So what else do you
this
have coming
nice.
Up? What else?
Very comfortable. Even in a suit.
Yeah. Or any other projects coming up?
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah, I do.
Well,
like I said, I work for the Movie and Music Network. I work for a company called Film On, a tailgating with Kato show, which still airs. Being with my honey, Lena Nguyen, we actually wrote a show and
the cooking.
Filmed the show and met with many networks. I can't name drop
that's
because
okay.
Lena obviously is contracted with a company called CBS, so we have to wait on everything.
Yeah, and you don't want to jinx it.
Jinx it? No, I can't jinx it.
No, you don't. No, you got that first check's got to clear.
But okay,
honey.
Yes. Yeah. Let's get back to this for a second.
Yeah.
Just
okay.
for a second, because this is the hottest thing. I and not hot to wear, but beautiful to wear.
Oh, it's all breathable too, and I designed everything. I mean, I sat down with
no,
design
you
team.
Didn't.
He's
I
hands on.
Did he really?
100%.
He did.
He has
100%
to be.
Hands on.
Yeah.
I did this, and I said, "What would I wear?" They asked, and then I said, "I'd wear this. It's comfortable. It's just, I love it. I hope they'll have the whole slack
you know, it reminds me of the Shark Tank. You've seen the show, right? So Rhonda's your shark.
Yeah.
She's the one going out.
Rhonda is pretty
so
much,
smart.
I got into the right hands of Rhonda. And not only that, Crystal Hefner, Hefner's wife,
yes.
has her line with us too. And her line is called Crystal Hefner.
Right.
So we have, and now everything's, you know, she's doing Home Shopping Network Canada as we speak right now. So.
This is going to take you everywhere.
Really?
Well, what kind of?
Yes, really. You know it is.
Is there a car in there or what?
No.
Hey.
You know what I
oh
mean.
Oh, my God, I'm flying.
Oh, gosh.
What kind of feedback have you gotten from people? What have you seen?
It's been pretty much your
I mean,
reaction, too.
I've said
too.
It's been a sensation, but what
yeah,
are people saying?
Yeah, people love these, and who wouldn't? Do you want to feel these?
They're really
here you go. Feel those. Tell me if you love them.
There you go.
I dare someone in the that I dare you to put you these go. On and walk in front of the show while we're taping. I dare you.
Yeah, and say you love slackerware.com. Yeah.
Chris, you want to feel this?
Now, Ty, can you wear these on ice?
I could probably wear the, not these, but the longer ones. But if he's going to do a woman's line,
yeah,
of course.
Yeah, you know what?
Absolutely.
Women actually wear these. Lena Nguyen wears the pair that you're wearing, and she does not take them off at all.
Lena Nguyen wears the pants.
She wears the pants?
She wears the pants, huh?
And controls actually the zipper, too. No, I'm kidding.
Oh! Boom, bang, boom.
Boom, bang, boom.
Well, I don't know.
on that.
well,
okay. It's so funny.
Okay, so it's online and
Rhonda's
trying to get
it. Yeah, if you want to get if they put nope. it, I don't know if it's on it, it's slackerware.com. Slackerware, you can see the whole line and everything has something what we wrote about the line. The great thing about the next line that I do for the men's is right. every tag you see would not only have the washing instructions, but a recipe for Kato potatoes. Or some kind of dip.
Clever.
Or watch games. So yeah,
that's
have,
so
but could
clever.
Could you ever have imagined 20 years ago that today you would be
With you guys?
No. selling Never. The, no, selling.
Doing your triple klutz.
Yes, right. Having a product out there like this?
Yeah.
The slackerware?
I kind of can't. it's something.
You're open to everything.
Yeah, it's sort of a thing that, you know how you have ideas from maybe 15 years ago and the right timing happens? I think that's kind of what happens in life. You know, something I said, I told Ryan, I said, I have the idea forever. And she, within a day, flew me down there, met a design team, and that's how it worked. I couldn't believe it myself.
Just don't get too big for your britches.
No, he's very humble.
Oh, Jim, stop it.
Jim.
I'll never
Jim
forget
Boxer.
You.
Jim Boxer.
All right.
Ever, Jim.
Thank you.
Am I right, Mary?
and I
that's love
it. You. Thank you. Thank
You're
you so
fantastic.
Much.
Thank you.
Thank
all
you.
Right.
And Mary. Thank you, Kato.
Thank you, Kato. Well, that's it for our show for tonight. Now, be sure to tune into our next show, as we'll be joined by Olympic champion and humanitarian, and according to Tai, one of her true aspirations, the legendary Rafer Johnson, will be here with us. It's certainly going to be an exciting night, so don't miss our next show with Olympian Rafer Johnson. Okay, that's our show for tonight. So for our guest, Kato Kaelin, and for my co-host, Tai Babilonia, and our director, Nick Ferretti, and the entire KBL crew, I'm Ken Boxer. Good night. Good night.
Ken Boxer Live is brought to you by the following sponsors. Sterling Properties of Santa Barbara, hometown feel, world-class service. Kisabella, Santa Barbara's most comprehensive day spa with award-winning service. Palazzo Restaurant, where people don't leave hungry or thirsty. The Wildcat Lounge, repeatedly voted Santa Barbara's best dance club. Harbor View Inn, welcome to Santa Barbara's premier four-diamond luxury boutique oceanfront hotel. Wendy Foster, Santa Barbara and Montecito's premier clothing store. The Eagle Inn, a family-owned hotel near the beach in Santa Barbara. Via Rosa Inn, let us pamper you in international style. And by Taffy's Pizza, delivery, pickup, or dine-in. Woody's Bodacious Barbecue, voted best barbecue in Santa Barbara for over 30 years. Santa Barbara Chicken Ranch, authentic Mexican style mesquite barbecue. Los Arroyos Mexican Restaurant, takeout. Santa Barbara Bar, finally, nutritious tastes great. Country Catering, Meat Market and Deli. Their food not only fills your plate, it nourishes the soul. Jack's Bagels and Bistro, serving the very best food in a friendly and relaxed atmosphere. Sammy's Camera, new location at 530 State Street. Summer Lee, makeup artist, stylist, and aesthetician. Perfect Computers, since 1990. The Ken Boxer Live musical theme by Mr. Michael J. Leslie. From all of us at Ken Boxer Live, I'm Darren Ron Heron. Good-